Aaron Burnett Out Front, weeknights at 7, only on CNN.
Her announcement made headlines around the world. Angelina Jolie underwent a double mastectomy after a genetic test showed she had a mutated BRCA1 gene, giving her an 87% chance of getting breast cancer. Her news put this company, Myriad Genetics, front and center. It's not a big player in the big picture of big biotech companies, but it has patents on the BRCA1 and 2 genes. When mutated, those genes are linked to an increased risk for breast and ovarian cancer. Because of those patents, Myriad has a monopoly on the test to find those mutations.
We believe that gene patents of this nature decrease access to testing for our patients, and the lack of competition in testing increases costs, decreases quality.
Dr. Roger Klein represents the Association for Molecular Pathology, which is challenging Myriad all the way to the Supreme Court.
The problem with patenting the human gene is that you're patenting a fundamental property of an individual.
Myriad Genetics declined our request for an on-camera interview, but told us what it patented are synthetic molecules that do not exist in the human body.
The question at the heart of the case before the Supreme Court is this: can genes or synthetic genes be patented, or are they products of nature that shouldn't be owned by anyone?
This case is such a big deal because so many people think the future of medicine is genetics. And how the law regards genes and synthetic genes will dictate how and whether companies invest to find new cures.
Myriad says it invested $500 million over 17 years in the project. That investment is paying off. Its Brock analysis test costs up to $4,000, often covered by insurance, and made up 82% of the company's revenue in fiscal 2012. The company's profit, $112 million. Biotech analyst Steve Brozak has followed Myriad for more than a decade.
Are they going to stop researchers from going out there and using their work? No. The idea is if someone else tries to do what they're doing commercially, they have to be protected, and that's the critical difference.
Myriad argues patenting genes encourages innovation and investment and hasn't prevented research. Others disagree.
We're at the cusp of the introduction of new technologies, and certainly these patents can do nothing but obstruct the introduction of those technologies.
I mean, Pop, it's amazing. You look at this test, you say $4,000, and I know that that may not be expensive relative to some other tests, but it seems that way to a lot of people. Yeah. And they say, well, look, if they have a monopoly on a gene,
right,
then that's part of the reason why this is expensive and out of reach for some people. How does it make sense?
So it's up to $4,000. Mm-hmm. It can be anywhere closer to $500. It depends how comprehensive of a test you get. And insurance, we found, covers this most of the time. The company also told me if people aren't insured and they qualify for the test, if they have reason to have it taken, then we will cover all of it or a great portion of it. Hmm. But this really comes down to this question of how do we get the best results? Do we incentivize companies by putting patents out there so that they will pour millions in and hope
right,
for a good result?
You own this gene, no one's going to compete,
right.
So you can put all the money in.
Or do you say every company jump in, yeah, compete, the cream rises to the top? And that's the core question that the Supreme Court is considering right now. We should get an answer from the court by the end of June, but I think it's also important to note only about 5 to 10% of women in the general population carry this gene mutation.
Hmm.
So it's in the headlines right now, but again,
right,
it's a small minority of women, but the company performs this test 250,000 times a year. So
wow,
it's frequently done.
All right, well, certainly a crucial question, one of probably a lot of people hadn't thought about, but when you do and you think
yeah,
about your health, it's a big one.